It was just the most empty feeling you could possibly have.
February 1st, 2003, a day that will forever be remembered for the Shuttle Columbia disaster. Seven U.S. astronauts died when it exploded on reentry, leaving debris scattered over Sabine County.
Many gathered today at the Patricia Huffman Museum in Hemphill to honor the astronauts. Among the speakers, the man who not only knew the astronauts personally, but gave the final okay for the shuttle to launch.
Yeah, he tells 12 News about that fateful day.
There are people that carry a heavy load to today, and I'm one of them. I knew the astronauts personally. They were my friends.
And retired Space Shuttle Launch Director Mike Leinbach says the astronauts trusted him as the man to give the final go for launch.
I made my final go on a gut check that said, have we done everything for these folks we could possibly do to make it a safe trip and for them to come home?
Leinbach says February 1st, 2003, started like any landing day at Kennedy Space Center.
I went to my control station in the Launch Control Center and watched the deorbit burn, and that went fine. And so then Columbia was bound to land at the Kennedy Space Center, couldn't land anywhere else.
And he wanted to be front and center to welcome the astronauts home.
And so then I raced out to the edge of the runway, expecting her to land with her seven astronauts, and it just didn't show up.
Leinbach says signs were mounting that something had gone horribly wrong.
We always got two sonic booms right prior to landing, about 3 minutes and 15 seconds prior to landing, and we didn't hear those booms. And then there was a large countdown clock between us and the runway, and that ticked down to zero, and Columbia should have been right there in front of us, and it just wasn't there.
The sonic booms not heard over the Space Center, causing chaos in East Texas.
I call that parallel confusion. We didn't know where it was. And at first, they didn't know what it was out here.
Leinbach says he returned to launch control, hoping beyond hope somehow the astronauts would be found safe. But those hopes were dashed as reports came across the TV of debris falling from the skies.
But when we saw the big trails in the sky over Hemphill and this area out here in East Texas, then we knew for sure the crew was gone. And we failed them this time. It hurt, and it hurts a lot.
A rapid response team deploying from Florida to Barksdale Air Force Base.
Then, a couple of the astronauts were already found. People were finding debris in their backyards and marking it and not touching it.
Their mission shifting to one of recovery. But the Columbia 7 would not die in vain. Using the lessons learned from the tragic disaster, the space program would forge ahead.
Every flight after Columbia was successful. We finished the International Space Station. And then retired the shuttle program.
15 years to the day, and still very fresh to Mike Leinbach.
Oh, it's like yesterday. I was a weekend anchor at KJAC when it all happened, and I can remember we were getting this information in very slowly, then very rapidly, and then all the images start to come in, lots of live cut-ins. It was an unbelievable day, quite tragic. And in my lifetime, I never thought that I would actually see this happen twice. I was just in sixth grade when...
Two shuttles.
Yeah, when the Challenger exploded. So a day we will all remember.
I am told that he said that of course, he came to Texas from Florida shortly after the disaster, and he said he was very impressed with the people of Sabine County and how they provided food and even washed their clothes free of charge just to help them in what they understood to be a terribly grievous incident. Of course, all the folks at NASA torn up about what happened there, so it was an important day
yes.
in our history. Patrick?